Hey there everyone, Ramesh here, back again with another video. In this video, we are going to understand Spring Boot React Full Stack Application Architecture. Alright, so if you can see here the architecture diagram, at the front end we have a React application architecture and at the back end we have Spring Boot application architecture. Okay, so let's first understand Spring Boot application architecture at the back end. And then we'll move to a React application architecture at the front end, and then we'll talk about how to integrate React and Spring Boot application together as a full stack application. Okay, great. Let's come to Spring Boot application architecture first. In a Spring Boot application, we have three layer architecture: controller layer, service layer, a repository, or a DAO layer. So controller layer holds all the Spring MVC controllers. Okay, basically controller process the request, that is a web request, and it will validate the request, and then it will send that request data to the service layer, and from the service layer it goes to repository layer, and then finally it's saved in a database. Well, controller layer basically holds Spring MVC controllers, and service layer holds all the business logic. Okay, we keep all our business logic in service layer. Apart from business logic, if you have any call to the third party REST APIs, then you can also keep that logic in a service layer. And repository or DAO layer, so basically we keep, you know, database related logic or persistence logic in this layer. And repository or DAO layer is basically responsible to talk with the database. So this is, you know, the pretty simple architecture at a backend with Spring Boot. Okay, so this is the typical architecture we use in Spring Boot applications. All right, now let's move to React application architecture. So in a React, we have different layer like router, components, and services. So different developers follow different architecture or a project structure in a React applications. But typically, I see that there are different components like components layer and service layer and router layer. So in a router, we typically configure a URL corresponding to components, and in components, we basically keep all the component related logic, that is UI logic, and there are different components are there in a React, that is functional component or class component, and we can use a React hooks in the components. All right, and we have a service, so we keep typically all the REST API calls in a service service layer, and we inject service layer in a components, and we call its method from the components. Okay, and if you use a Redux, then you may have different layers in a React application. And to look at here in a service component or service class, we need to use a third party library to make a REST API call, because React is not concerned with HTTP. We have to use third-party HTTP library to make a REST API call from the React application. So ArcGIS is one of the popular HTTP library that we can use to make a REST API call from the React application. All right, so this is how the typical structure in a React application. Now in terms of integration, so from the Spring Boot application, we expose the REST endpoints, and the React application basically consumes the REST APIs. And as I mentioned earlier, React is not concerned with HTTP. So in order to make a REST API or AJAX call from the React, we have to use third-party library, for example, ArcGIS library, okay? Or we can also use a JavaScript fetch API. Okay, so this is how basically we integrate a React application with Spring Boot by using third-party HTTP library or a fetch API. All right, so this is pretty much about Spring Boot or React full stack application architecture. And if you want to develop, you know, full stack application using Spring Boot and React, I have a free, course where I have shown you how to develop a complete Spring Boot React full stack application. So let me quickly walk you through that. So look at here in my YouTube channel, I have published React.js Spring Boot Code full stack application course. So this course has around 25 videos. And in this course, you will learn everything about, you know, how to integrate React with Spring Boot, and you will basically learn, you know, how to develop full stack application using React.js and Spring Boot. And this course is also available on my own platform. So you can just go to courses.javaguides.net. Okay, here you can find ReactJS Spring Boot Code Full Stack Application. I made this course as a free, so you can go ahead and you can join this course. I will provide a link in the description of this video so that you can quickly join this course, or you can, you know, watch this course on my YouTube channel as well. So in this course you are going to learn how to build a React and Spring Boot Full Stack application step by step, line by line coding. Okay, I highly recommend you guys, you know, to visit this course. So this course is very popular on my YouTube channel, and it reached around 231,000 within 8 or 9 months. Okay, so I highly recommend you guys to just check out this course. I'm damn sure that you will find this course useful. Alright guys, I hope you found this video useful, and I hope you pretty much understood how the Spring Boot React Full Stack application architecture looks like, and how the integration happened between React application and Spring Boot. So if you find this video useful, then subscribe to my YouTube channel and let me know if you want this kind of videos. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.